Hi everyone, so this is my first ever video on YouTube and I just wanted to show you all how I do an infill on my own nails. So I'm currently wearing BIAB in Luna by the Gelbottle, and I'm just going to start by filing this all down ready for the infill. The nails I'm taking off in this video I had on for 3 weeks, and it was just the biabluna finished with the extreme shine top coat by the Gelbottle. So all I'm doing here is just removing that top coat and just taking a little bit of the bulk out of that biab. I'm ready to put a bit more on and just infill. Next, I'm just going to push those cuticles back nice and gently. Next, I'm just going to come in with my e-file and a cuticle bit, just removing any dead skin around that cuticle so we don't get any lifting. Here I'm just giving a quick dust off with my nail brush to remove any excess dust. I followed with a wipe over with acetone, ready to start applying the builder in a bottle. So I start just by placing it slightly away from the cuticle, pulling it down the nail to the free edge, and then also pushing it back up to the cuticle just to get it nice and close. So now I've applied my second coat of BIAB, I'm just going to turn my hand over just to let the BIAB level out just for a few moments or so before popping my hand under the lamp. Now that that's cured, I'm just showing you what the result is. What I'm going to do now is just wipe over with isopropyl alcohol and then we'll begin filing. For my filing routine, I start with the sidewalls first, holding the file at 90 degrees to the nail, working my way around up around the cuticle and then down the nail bed. There's no bulk to come off here, I'm literally just refining that shape, making it nice and smooth, ready for when we apply the gel polish. Just tidying up that free edge now, and then we'll move on to the next nail. You'll see that I'm just pulling that skin back with my thumb, just so I can get right in there with my file. I forgot to mention as well that I'm using the NSI 150-150 grit. You can see on this one it's a bit thicker towards the free edge, so that just needed a bit more filing just to get it nice and smooth and even all the way down the nail. So you can see on this one here, it's just looking a bit thin towards the cuticle. Sorry if, of course, I've not put enough BIAB on initially, or I've just filed away too much just now. But as long as I make it nice and smooth, I don't think it should affect the end result too much. Just finishing filing my little finger now. This is the one that I always struggle with. For some reason I always end up getting cramp and have to give my hand a bit of a break and then carry on with it. So I'm going to show you all the nails in just a minute before I give them a buff over and then a wipe down with isopropyl alcohol, and then I'll be ready to apply the gel polish. Just do a quick once over on all the nails and finishing up just going under that free edge. I find it gets rid of any little bits that are just straggling on the end, and makes it better for when I do come to apply the gel polish. Okay, so I'm happy with these now. You can see just how thin I have applied that BIAB and how thin the nails are now that I've filed them down. This is absolutely plenty of strength for me, for my nails, and allows me to grow them. I don't tend to get any breakages, and these now, once I've applied the gel polish, should last me about 3 weeks. So coming in now with my gel polish, I'm using Grand Canyon, again from the gel bottle. It's a really earthy red and I just love it. It covers fantastic with just one coat, but once you pop that second coat on, it just absolutely pops. Okay, so I'm ready to cure those now, and then I'm just going to come in now with my second coat. Okay, so finally, just finishing off with the Extreme Shine top coat. This just makes it really stand out. It's so, so shiny. And again, I just absolutely love it. Okay, so just finishing off now. I hope you find this helpful. And if you did like it, then please don't forget to like, share and subscribe. And I'll see you guys all again soon. Thanks for watching.